Let's talk about the live streaming protocol, MPEG-Dash. A little over a decade ago, there were quite a few proprietary protocols scrambling to gain widespread adoption as the use of RTMP for playback began to decline. The Moving Picture Experts Group decided that an open standard needed to be created against these proprietary protocols, and so with the backing of over 50 companies, developed Dynamic Adaptive Streaming over HTTP, more commonly called MPEG-Dash. This protocol doesn't require specific codecs as it's codec agnostic, it works with any HTML5 player, and it uses the more secure TCP standard for transport. Its design makes it perfect for adaptive bitrate streaming with a latency of between 6 to 30 seconds. That latency can be tuned much lower with the help of chunk transfer encoding. So, with all these positives, why hasn't there been widespread adoption? The simple answer is it's not supported natively on iOS. While it works on all modern browsers, including Safari, its inability to play on iOS and Apple TV has forced a wider adoption of HLS over MPEG-Dash. As iOS represents 13% of mobile devices, the more widespread use of HLS probably won't change anytime soon. But for those of you who want to get out of the H.264, H.265 stranglehold of HLS, can ignore Apple device users, and want a low latency by utilizing chunk encoded and chunk transferred CMAF, MPEG-Dash is a great option and a true international standard. And if you can't ignore those Apple devices, you can always transcode for both with media server software like Wowza Streaming Engine. Then just let the player you choose fall back to the higher latency HLS stream when MPEG-Dash isn't supported. At least until low latency HLS becomes more viable. To get more help in determining the best solution for your need, just contact us here at Wowza.